Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining BGP attributes and how they are used to determine the best path. BGP is the routing protocol used on the internet. Like all routing protocols, it allows routing devices to exchange information to determine the best path to any particular destination. Internal gateway protocols, or IGPs like EIGRP or OSPF, will typically use the criteria of shortest path or lowest cost to determine the best route. BGP, however, needs to be much more versatile in determining the best path because the best path over the internet is rarely the shortest. BGP evaluates multiple paths to a destination by checking a series of attributes in sequential order. If a path is preferred according to a particular attribute, it's chosen, and any other possible paths are simply discarded. If paths are equal according to that particular attribute, the process continues to the next attribute. This goes on until an attribute is reached that identifies the best path with the appropriate tie-breaking criteria. Once determined, the best path is then installed in the routing table for forwarding packets. So let's take a look at a practical example. Here we have a host with an IP address of 20.20.20.10 that wants to reach a web server with an IP address of 30.30.30.10. Now the BGP routers found within AS140 are aware of the 30.30.30.0/24 network, because it belongs to this AS. Now, BGP will be used to inform all neighboring ASs that this network belongs to AS140. And this is done by propagating this information to those ASs using BGP updates. Thus, all other ASs are informed that AS140 is the owner of this network. So if you want to reach it, you should route traffic towards AS140. Now, BGP routers within all other ASs we see here will know that this network belongs to AS140, and they will also be informed of the AS path, the path to get to that destination. So ultimately, R1, our BGP router in AS100, will receive information about how to get to that 30.30.30.0/24 network, and it will actually receive two AS paths. It will receive AS path 100, 150, 140, which is depicted by the green path, and it'll also receive the 100, 190, 160, 140, which is indicated by the red path. Now remember that the BGP update that is received by R1 doesn't only include the various AS paths as shown, but it also includes a whole series of information about the various BGP attributes that exist for each path. So now it's up to our BGP router to decide which path is the best path to be chosen, and thus that routing information will be installed in the local routing table. Now the BGP router will look at these two paths and will compare the associated attributes that it has received for each one. The attributes are always compared in a specific order, and if there's a tie for a particular attribute, the next one in the sequence is compared. This process continues until there is a tie break. So let's take a look at these attributes. We'll just list them here, so we won't go into any detail. You may recognize some of them, while others may seem completely foreign to you. So R1 receives BGP updates that tell it that there are two paths to the 30.30.30.0/24 network. And it will also receive varying attributes for each path. So R1 will then compare the following attributes in the following order. First, it'll take a look at the weight. Now, this attribute is a value that exists in the BGP update for each path. Now, this attribute is actually a Cisco-specific attribute. It's not included in the official definition of BGP, but it has been largely adopted by many other vendors as well. Then we have the local preference attribute. This is used to select the preferred outbound path for a router within the same AS. Next, we have the locally originated attribute. routes originated by the local router are preferred over routes from other routers. Next, we have the AS path attribute. Now, this represents the path a route should take through autonomous systems to get to the destination. A shorter AS path is always preferred. Now, before we go on, let me just mention that I did say at the beginning that the shortest path is not so important to BGP. However, we do see here that the shortest AS path is actually of some importance, since it is one of the attributes that's checked to determine the best path. And it is the shortest AS path that is preferred. However, I would like to point out that it isn't the first attribute, but it's the fourth attribute in the list of those that is checked. So that gives us an idea of its level of importance in the whole scheme of things. Now, secondly, I'd also like to say that if we look at our diagram here, and if we assume that all other BGP settings are set to their default values, then it's at this point that one of the two paths will be chosen over the other. Essentially, the tie-breaking criteria here, or the tie-breaking attribute, is the AS path, because one of those AS paths is actually shorter, and it's the one that's depicted by the green line, AS 100, 150, and 140. But let's assume, for the sake of our example here, that the AS path is actually equal. If that were the case, what are the additional attributes that need to be examined in order to determine that best path? Well, next we would check the origin attribute. Now, this attribute signifies the source of the path information, whether it came from an IGP or whether it came from BGP itself. Information from an IGP is preferred over information that has been received via BGP. Next, we have the multi-exit discriminator, or MED. This attribute is communicated to neighboring ASs, indicating the preferred path into the local AS in the event that there are multiple connections between two ASs. Then we have the eBGP over IBGP attribute. Paths learned via external BGP are preferred over those learned via internal BGP. Next, the shortest IGP path to the BGP next hop is preferred. So the path with the shortest interior gateway protocol distance to the next hop is selected. If those are equal, then we take a look at the oldest path for eBGP routes. Specifically for eBGP, if all else is equal, it is the oldest path that is preferred. If we still have a tie, then we look at the router ID. The path with the lowest originator router ID is preferred. And finally, if our router ID is the same, then we come to the very last attribute, which will always be a tiebreaker. If all else is equal, it is the path with the lowest neighbor BGP router ID that is preferred. Now, this was a general overview, and I'm sure you have questions about each of these attributes. I will do my best to create a video for each one so that each one is explained in detail. But the point here is to understand the process, to understand the overall algorithm that is used by BGP to determine the best path. Also note that the list of attributes here may be somewhat different depending upon the implementation and the vendor. But the list I'm showing you here is the most commonly used one. And also, I'd like to note that all of the attributes are not always used all the time. Some are considered optional, while others are mandatory. Now, before I end off, I'd just like to mention one more thing here. The official BGP standard is published in the appropriate RFC, and it's freely available for anyone to view. And I have a link to it in the description below. So in summary, a BGP router may receive multiple paths to a particular destination. Within a BGP update, each path is accompanied by a series of what are known as BGP attributes. BGP uses the comparison of these attributes of the paths in a particular order to determine the best path. If an attribute of these multiple paths is equal, the next attribute is examined and compared until there is a tie break. BGP requires this level of complexity to allow for the multitude of routing options and flexibility needed to route between ASs. And finally, attributes can be either mandatory or optional, as they are described in the official definition of BGP in the RFC. Well, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click the thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments. And please subscribe to get updates of newly published videos. This is Lazarus at telecom tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.